Last week, I made a part one of things that the Grand Theft Auto series needs to do right to make it elite. But this is part two. And in this video, right, I'll detail a feature that needs to be in GTA to make it the best thing to ever exist. And if they don't have it, it's gonna be shit. You're listening, Rockstar Games? Alright, let's go. But the one thing I want to build on from the last video is the loading screens, which take way too fucking long to load. But the reason it takes this long to load is because of graphics. Probably, I don't know, right? But fuck it, let's assume that's what's causing it. Alright? Seriously, right? I hate graphics. Like, I don't understand the boner that some people have for graphics, right? Because they don't really do anything for me. Like, oh, so realistic. It's like I'm right there. Yeah, it does nothing for me. But the main reason that I hate graphics, right, is because I can't help but think that a simplifying of graphics would allow for a lot more interesting features to take their place. Interesting theory. Because Jesus Christ, man, a PlayStation 5 or 6 at this rate, who knows, right? Processing PlayStation 2 graphics? Mate, that downgrade and simplification could make the game run a lot faster. Mate, the game would probably load in half a second. And the time saved by processing this simpler shit could be used to load more fun shit, such as full interactivity. Hit me up with this one, right? Because this would make Grand Theft Auto step up to a whole new level. And this comes in two parts. Okay, so part one is building interactivity. Listen, I'm sure everyone agrees with this, right? But it would be awesome if every building had a randomly generated interior that you could enter, which would be way easier to generate and load with your graphics, right? So every restaurant, every hospital, every store, every normal residential house, right? You should be able to enter or break into. And two, right? Mate! NPC interactivity using AI. Like, Jesus Christ, man, have you seen how amazing AI is getting now? Like, ChatGPT 4.0 just came out like 2 weeks ago or something, right? And it is insane. Like, you can talk to it in real time, right? And it gives impressive as fuck human-like replies, and you can have a proper conversation about literally anything with it.
ChatGPT, how are you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. Thanks for asking. What's up?
So my friend Barrett here, I want you to tell him a bedtime story about robots and love.
A bedtime story about robots and love? I got you covered.
How insane is that? But listen, I know what you're thinking, right? Oh, come on, Grade. That's ChatGPT. That's irrelevant. It's going to be a hot fucking minute before AI can be implemented into video games on any meaningful level, right? Wrong, mate. Because about 6 months ago, there was a video I saw on YouTube where they already have this thing in Unreal Engine 5, right? Where you can talk to NPCs via your voice and have a fucking conversation in real time with them.
Dang, dude, when's the last time you got a haircut?
I actually just got one last week. Maybe it wasn't good enough.
You're all dressed up. You have a job interview?
I'm actually on vacation, but thanks for the compliment.
Would you rather have feet for hands or hands per feet?
Hands for person feet, obviously.
What? So mate, combine all of this shit, right, and get that in Grand Theft Auto 6. Mate, that needs to happen. Mate, do you understand the possibilities this interactivity with people in buildings could open up? Like, mate, you could go to the club and try and hit on girls, right? Maybe have a feature, right, where you can break into homes and rob them. You could go to church and listen to a ChatGPT-generated sermon. Mate, you could even go to a therapist every week and have sessions, right? And talk about what caused you to stop making videos for 8 years. Huh. Mate, the possibilities are endless. Seriously, fuck a life of crime, right? Grand Theft Auto will become the perfect game when there are so many possibilities of things you can do in it that doing anything crime-related is among one of the more boring options because you can basically do whatever the fuck you want, right? And it... Oh my God! And it becomes the metaverse! You better hurry up and get your shit together, Zuckerberg! Rockstar might just beat you to it! Maybe that's the big revolution that gaming today needs. That maybe it's time to stop going forward with graphics and take a step backwards instead, so that other more important features can shine. And mate, plenty of games have already gone backwards on the graphics end in the past. Like the Zelda games, for example, right? They pulled it back with the graphics for Wind Waker and A Link Between Worlds. Mega Man went all the way back with Mega Man 9 and 10, and games like Shovel Knight and Undertale opted for 8-bit graphics from the very start. So why not Grand Theft Auto 2? Like, don't get me wrong, right? I do want some graphics. Like, I don't want to be playing Grand Theft Auto with Atari graphics or something, do you know what I mean? But beyond a certain point, yeah, I don't need graphics better than this. Like, San Andreas and Vice City were my personal favourites. Give me that any day of the week, mate. Like, mate, again, right? Having shittier graphics could allow for a lot more fun possibilities. So fucking do it, innit? Dickhead. And if you haven't already watched it, right, go and watch part one, mate. Next week, we're going to have a bit of barbell study, like the video and buy some shirts, innit? Cheers, mate. Peace. And listen, really quickly, and I don't mean to interrupt the video with some bad news about the channel, right? But I'm getting sued. Listen, I got served papers about a week ago because I launched a new merch line and website recently, right? Called 1969 Clothing. And listen, I've just started, so I've got a few designs on it, right? Like, I've got this James Corden Isn't Funny one. I've got one or two brand new GTA-related ones and a few more planned, right? But one of the designs, right, was this black man one. Listen, it's a play on Pac-Man, right? But with a little racist twist, do you know what I mean? Listen, right, I think it's some innocent, funny shit. But one customer who must have bought a shirt, right, is suing me because he gained so much sex appeal overnight from wearing my merch in public that he got four girls pregnant, and now he's suing me for the child support that he has to pay. So legal disclaimer, right? Make sure you keep a condom on you at all times, right? Because my merch is clinically proven to get you a shitload more female attention whilst wearing it, right? And I will not be liable for any mistakes you make wearing it. So go buy a few shirts to help me with legal fees, innit? Right, cheers, boys. Peace.